glad to have you with us in the studio. I'm Reese Davis, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Time for some early season action from the high-powered offenses in the Big 12. We've done all we can do here. Time to tee it up. Let's send it out to Brad and Kirk for the call. David and I will be with you at halftime.
Texas, also called Cowtown, the site for this game. Let's head down to the coin toss now. It's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. The kicker's got the ball set up, and we're ready to get this thing started. He'll return it from the one. Makes it to the 22-yard line. TCU's coaching staff, the fans, I think everybody's been waiting to see this kid play, and here he is.
He's a star quarterback. He seems to bring everything to the table. The crowd, I think, senses he's ready to have a big day. And when your star quarterback feels good at playing at home and he gets off to a good start, some big things can happen for this offense.
Throws, and that one's going to hit the ground incomplete. TCU's got a guy that statistically is leading the conference right now, and he has got the attention of everybody in the country, including the coordinators. From their own 22-yard line, second down.
Is tough as nails, Brad. He's going to sit in that pocket and give himself a chance. The only problem is, at some point, you've got to have a feel, almost that sixth sense on when to get out of there and avoid the pressure, or just to throw the ball before you get hit.
Gets it out in a hurry. Stays in bounds and made a nice catch.
Good job by the offensive line to pick up the linebacker on the blitz. That gave the quarterback enough time to find his man for a nice game.
First and 10, ball on the 40. And he's tackled around the 49-yard line.
It's a nice job by the quarterback to pitch the ball, and it got him a first down.
Sticks after another first down.
Impressive drive by this offense so far. I really like what they're doing by keeping this defense on their heels and moving the ball downfield.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 30. Deep pass to the end zone. Touchdown, Horned Frogs. He splits the uprights with the extra point. Reese Davis joins us in the studio with this update. Reese?
Let's take a look at some action in the Big 12. And for UTEP, they've now won 3 in a row.
All right, thanks, Reese. Back to the live action here. Wilson, ready to kick. Moore fields it at the one. They bring him down, and they bring him down hard on that one. The quarterback brings his troops out onto the field for the first drive of the game. They come out on an empty backfield. And now he's got room to run. He's to the 40. Down the sideline. At the 30. To the 20. To the 10. Touchdown, Owls.
Wow, he looked like a running back out there. And that's just what you want when you're calling the option.
Here's the PAT to tie this thing up. He makes the PAT. Ford has his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick this one off. He's to the 20. He's taken down at the 32-yard line. They did a great job on their last drive, moving the ball down the field for a touchdown. Let's see if they can duplicate that on this drive.
Well, it's one thing to have speed. It's another thing to have an idea of what you're doing and how to attack a defense. And right now, these wide receivers have done an outstanding job in being able to make their reads and getting out of their breaks, and the quarterbacks hit the ball right on them.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 44-yard line. Goes to the receiver, incomplete.
That pass didn't look exactly right when it left his hand. Sometimes you don't get a great grip on the ball, and it comes out a little wobbly.
Quick throw to the tight end. Sanders picks up about a yard with that completion.
That'll make it 39.
Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 46. They go with the back, and he's hammered in the backfield.
Good, solid defense there to force him into a fourth down situation.
Wilson is the punter. Gets out to about the 31.
For the last time we saw this off the field, they drove the length of the field. And you think back to what that defensive coordinator tried to do. He tried to change some things up, but nothing seemed to work. It's going to be interesting to see how he can have an impact on this drive.
And they get nice yardage on that run.
That'll make it second and four.
Quick strike to the receiver. Brought down the 39-yard line. That's a deep two. Tackled after a decent pickup.
That's good for 5 yards. That makes it first and 10.
Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
That makes it second and six.
He's tackled at the 43.
Maybe after a nice run like that, you try to go up in the air with a play-action pass.
Patriot!
the 44-yard line. Second down. And he's going to lose big yardage. He's tackled immediately after the catch. Convert another one and keep this drive going. Five wide. It's the grab and he's got the first. He's tackled in the open field. Throws this one away. Here's play number 10 on the drive. Inside the 10. And down he goes at the 10-yard line.
That's a gain of 16. That makes it first and 10.
Tackle made around the 3-yard line.
Cooper on the tackle at the 3-yard line. That'll bring up second and 3.
And he throws it away. Well, they'll line it up again on third down. 2 for 2 so far on this drive. They bring him down in the backfield.
The entire defense just collapsed on that run and got penetration into the backfield. Nice job by the safety to clean up the mess.
So at the end of one, we're even at 7 in this one. And we welcome you back to the action here. Just about set to start the second quarter. Rice could take the lead with this field goal. The kick is up, and he got it.
And you got to think they're pretty happy with holding him to a field goal right there.
Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Excellent kick. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. They go to the run, and he's tackled in the backfield for a loss.
That makes it second and 10.
From their own 23-yard line, second down. There's a strike complete, and he's taken down at the 28-yard line.
That'll bring up third and 6.
Quick pass, and he finally steps out at the 45. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 45-yard line. Got a man, but he's tackled back behind the line of scrimmage. Loss of a yard.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch.
from the 46-yard line. It's second down.
Ready!
He tackles him for a loss.
He just never had a chance to get any running room. The defense was on him almost as soon as the ball was snapped.
Still not enough for the first.
Well, the offense hurt themselves by digging themselves into a hole on first and second down, so the defense didn't really have to put too much thought in how to defend on that third down.
The punter is going to try to pin them deep in their own territory with a good punt here. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Rice is up a field goal. He's taken down right around the 22-yard line.
On the offensive line, they've got to do a better job of holding their blocks, or else this quarterback's going to be pulling turf out of his face mask all game.
Defense hoping for another sack here on third and long. He airs it out, and he's got it for the 20, the 10. Touchdown, Rice! And for Black, he's up to 100 yards and catches.
You know, if you were to ask this defense, who wants to cover this guy? I bet you nobody's going to raise their hand because this receiver is embarrassing them.
And we've still got time left here in the second quarter, so this kid could really end up with a big game. Converts the extra point. Ford has the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep. He's to the 20. He makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line. Motley's stats right now are pretty impressive, but the team has not been impressive. They're struggling despite the fact that he's playing well here in the first half.
Brad, I think he's played well enough for this team to be playing much better as a group. Unfortunately, the rest of his teammates aren't seeming to follow his lead, and I think that's going to be the real challenge for him as they go into the second half, is being able to get this team to be able to rise up their play to where he's playing, and then they've got a shot to be able to come back and win this game.
4 yards on that play.
You don't have to throw it deep to have success. Any sort of completion can help boost an offense's confidence.
From their own 24-yard line, it's second down. And he just gets rid of it. Slings it out there incomplete.
That's a miscommunication between a quarterback and a wide receiver right there. They need to get their signals straight.
The punt upcoming, and they're going to come after this one. He punts it away, and it's a great kick. Moore takes it to 25. He makes it to the 38-yard line. Rice is really putting a hurting on him right now.
Well, you wonder if it was a coach or a player who kind of lit the fire under this offense, but we've seen a completely different-looking team, and they're executing at a much higher level.
Well, the offense heading back out onto the field after that kick, hoping to turn this drive into another touchdown.
I love to watch a quarterback when he can really get into sync with his wide receivers. These guys have worked all week on their preparation to attack this defense, and right now it's really paying off.
Second and 6 coming up here. Ball on the 42. He's at midfield. inside the 30. And they make the stop at about the 21.
That's a gain of 37 on the ball. First down.
Larry, Larry, Larry. 57 to Mike. Mark 57. Here we go, D. Check three, check three.
Going for it all to the end zone. Oh, he had the pick and he dropped it. The offense took an errant shot into the end zone, and I'll tell you what, that one should have been picked off.
Yeah, I'm sure he's going to hear all about that from his teammates when he comes over to the sidelines.
Gets out to around the 12. Bring him down at the 4-yard line. The Owls call a timeout. That's their second of the half. First and goal from the 3. They're knocking on the door. Tackle around the 1-yard line. He scrambles. And he can't get away from the pressure.
The defenders played the snap count perfectly. They found the path into the backfield and didn't let the quarterback get away.
Zings it over the middle. Touchdown. Tacks on the extra point. Let's go to the studio for this Reese Davis update.
Time to check in on what's happening in the nation's top 10. The Hokies' rushing attack can be difficult to stop, and they get into the end zone for a touchdown. Notre Dame has the edge 24-7.
All right, thanks a lot, Reese. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Things are on the verge of getting out of hand before we even hit the half. These next few drives are going to go a long way in determining what kind of game this will end up being. Finds his man, and they take him down immediately. Donaldson picks up 6 yards with that grab. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Slings it, and he's tackled at the 48-yard line.
A quarterback's best friend is a receiver he can count on to catch the ball every time he drops back the pass.
Here we go. Red 68. Red.
Throws it in a hurry. Brought down at the 40.
The quarterback and his receiver make a great play here and convert on an early down.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. I guess he'll throw this one as far as he can and hope for a miracle. He chucks it downfield. Can't haul it in. So at the end of the half, Rice leads it 24-7.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here completely locked in on that first half. These offenses seemingly took advantage of every opportunity to make a big play. They were prolific, explosive plays at every turn, offensive coordinators dialing up great calls at just the right moment, it seems.
No, it did seem that way, and everything worked. But there's also the other side of the equation, too, and we talk about it all the time. You want to make top 10 plays, and you want to be celebrated. You want to see your clip for a couple days on SportsCenter. But when you're on defense, you can't always make a big SportsCenter play. You can't try to decapitate somebody every single time. It's okay to make the easy tackle, grab their legs, wrap them up. Right now, a lot of sloppy tackling is making the offensive guys look 10 times better than they should be. You don't have to make SportsCenter. You could just make the regular, normal, everyday play.
David and I will stay locked in on everything going on in college football. It's going to wrap it up here in the studio. Just about time to get you out to your second half. Brad and Kirk, ready with a call.
All right, Reese and David, thanks, guys. Second half action just about ready to start here.
He kicks it off, and he got all of that one.
Rice's game plan couldn't have imagined things to go this well. They've scored 24 points in a row.
They're set to go for another round.
White up the gut, and he hits him hard at the 24-yard line. That's a great tackle at the 33-yard line. He makes his way to about the 42. First down. And they get nice yardage on that run.
That makes it first and 10.
From the 36-yard line, it's first down.
And they get him in the backfield for a loss.
Did you see how quickly he was able to get into the backfield and make that tackle? Not many guys that big can move that fast.
This is the eighth play of this drive. And he's going to come up with a sack.
Boy, this pass rush is sometimes scary. They're really getting after the quarterback now.
Well, they've converted one third down play on this drive, but now they're faced with a third and long.
Here we go.
Here they come. Wants to go long and done. Can't connect. That ball had interception written all over it, but the defender couldn't hang on.
I think the quarterback there was a little too intent on hitting that receiver.
And they could really put their opponent in bad field position with a good punt here. This punt bounces into the end zone, and this will be a touchback.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game.
Gives it to the back. Gets out to about the 21.
Pickup of a yard for the tailback.
That brings up second and nine.
We've got a second and nine here.
Ball on the 21.
Mike 51. Mike 51. Set.
Tackle made at the 34-yard line.
To get the first here on second down.
They're running it. Let's go. Whitey.
He gets it out to about the 47-yard line. From the 46-yard line, second down. They try to run up the middle, but met in the backfield.
Good job by the defense to overpower the offensive line and drop the back for a loss.
This is the eighth play of the drive. The quarterback in the gun. Empty backfield. Five wide receivers in the formation. And he's level at the 23-yard line.
That makes it second and two.
It's the ninth play of the drive. Got a man. Watch out here. So the completion goes for about 5 yards and a first down.
And I like the decision the quarterback made on this play. He didn't try to force a deep pass. Instead, he just threw a little dump-off pass that was good enough for a first down.
From the 18-yard line, first down. He's taken down right around the 10-yard line.
That makes it second and two.
That's three down and one to go. The Owls lead it by 17. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. They'll spread the field with five wide. Quick throw to the back, it's incomplete.
This quarterback has got to do a better job of looking off defenders and allow his covered receivers some room to improvise and get free.
We're at the 12th play of the drive. We're still early in the fourth quarter, but that was a huge stop. And now with the lead, they're going to get the football back and an opportunity to stretch the lead. So it's fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. Anderson, left side. Touchdown, Horned Frogs. The extra point. Wilson has his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick this one off. Nice kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
That makes it second and six.
He might have a chance. He's taken down around the 48-yard line.
That's a D. First down.
Fights forward to about the 46.
Some daylight.
Gains his way to the 26-yard line.
Awesome running here on third down. That can bring a lot of confidence to an offense when they can pull that off so successfully.
Pass complete and taken down immediately.
That's good for a gain of 7 yards. That'll make it second and four.
So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first.
Job here, but let me tell you something. That wideout was left out to dry that time.
And this play is number 8 on the drive. Less than 3 minutes in the game. On the throw, incomplete pass. Fourth down. So the field goal unit is on the field. They'll try for 3 points. It's up, and he got it. Fields at the goal line. Gets to about the 24-yard line. Rice's defense has been a force to be reckoned with, especially in this game.
Well, they have stepped up today. They just seem to be dialed into what this offense is trying to do. Good job against the run. They've been very physical. What I love is how relentless they run to the football.
They'll take over here, ready to start a new series. Throws incomplete, intended for his wideouts. Boy, would he like to have that one back.
Yeah, you're right. This offense relies so much on timing. And as you saw there, when their timing gets knocked off, they have a tough time connecting on plays like this.
From their own 24-yard line, it's second down. And they make the stop, the 37-yard line. Short yardage situation here. Second down and one.
Three down. Oh, Mike 51.
There's a strike complete. They'll bring him down around the 44-yard line.
Good job to identify the weakness in this defense. Any good offense will exploit those holes over and over again.
Just over 2 minutes in the game. Throw to the tight end. Tackle around the 20-yard line.
If you're the defense, who do you try to cover this guy with? He's too fast for most linebackers. He's too big for most corners. You have to rely on your safeties, who generally aren't very good in one-on-one coverage. Well, you know this defense is going to come after you. There's no doubt about that. And as an offense, you have to be prepared for that. And that play, they made them pay for blitzing.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here.
Ready, lighting,
quickly to the the tight end incomplete.
I love to see the offense try to get the football to the tight end here. These guys can do a lot of damage to the defense, but this time, the defense does a really good job of separating the big fella from the football.
Here's the eighth play of the series. Throws complete, touchdown. Only a one-score difference now after that big, big touchdown. And he converts the extra point. He's taken down at the 40-yard line.
So they recover the kick, and now the game's probably in their hands. If they can hang on to the ball or score, I don't see how they can lose.
You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. Rice with a six-point lead. Gets to about the 37-yard line. And the halfback carries for a pickup of three. The Horned Frogs taking their first time out of the half. From the 37-yard line, second down. Nice run, and he's brought down. White gains about 5 yards on the run. TCU's going to have to use their second time out of the half. He gets to about the 24-yard line.
I think the defense put everything into that sequence of plays, and for the offense to come up with a first down really is demoralizing for the defense.
First and 10. Ball on the 24-yard line. Brought down around the 23-yard line. They'll line up with five wide receivers. Tailback brought down for a loss. So we're looking at another third down here. Gets out to around the 12.
You know, Brad, that's the second third down that they've been able to convert on this drive. And this offense right now has really showed a lot of poise and been able to hold on to the football and try to maintain this drive.
Motley's big performance today, it's going to be tough for him to celebrate, though, because they end up with a loss.
Well, it's a tough day for his team. You know, he had a great individual performance, but you know, you think about the team first, obviously, if you're this star player, and he cannot be happy with, even though he had a great game, this team ends up losing the football.
That brings this broadcast to a close. 3A Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.